I'm Sushmita from Miss Pink Shoes and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a tutorial on this look right here. So I've gone for really soft halo eyes with plum nude lips. So I had put up a picture on my Insta story and my Snap story a couple of days back and it was of me wearing a halo eye and a lot of you wanted to see a halo eye tutorial. So that's why I decided to do this. So I love the way this look turned out because it's really simple looking and you can literally wear this with any look. You can switch over the lip color, you can change the color on your eyes, go as bold or as soft as you want with this, but I like the softness that this look has. It has that mild iridescence in the center and the whole thing is just really well blended and I just love the way this turned out because it takes not more than 5 minutes and it looks beautiful. So yes, if you'd like to know how to get this look, then please keep on watching. To prime my skin today, I'm going to be using the Zero Pore Separation Cream by PAC. The way this primer works, guys, it's really like amazing. I love the finish this gives my makeup and it just makes my skin look so good. So with my fingers, I've just applied it all over my face and I'm just blending it out. And I'm also taking it down my neck. I'm going to conceal my face using the Dermacolor Concealer in the shade D5. Taking it using a brush. So I'm taking this mainly onto my under eyes because as you can see, they are super dead today. And now just going over my cheeks because I have a lot of spots there. And also around my mouth. And finally, I'm giving a shot to a silly sponge. So I ordered this one from TS Cosmetics. So like I would use my blender, I'm just going over all the areas that I've applied my concealer onto to blend it out. And it is doing a decent job, I must say. But it is quite a bit of hard work, like my hands are hurting a little because I have to blend this a lot. Like my blender blends my makeup much faster. This takes some time, but it gives a good coverage, like it does not eat up any product, which is amazing. So I like the finish this has given me, but it took a lot of time and my hands are hurting. So that's sort of the downside, but the finish is good and it did not eat up any product because it literally can't, it's a silicone sponge. So that's good. So probably for that, I like it. But I don't know, I have to use it a couple of times to, you know, really know how I feel. But blending wise, it has done a good job. For foundation today, I'm going to be trying out the Dream Velvet Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation by Maybelline. I've had this for so long and I don't know why I've just never used it. So let's give this a shot too. So it's a proper mousse-like consistency, if you guys can see. And it looks a little light. I think it's a little light for my skin. I don't know. Once I blend it out, I will know. Going in with the silly sponge, I'm just gonna blend the foundation out. It is a tad bit light, but I don't mind it. Like, it's not even like half a shade lighter. It's just slightly lighter to my skin, so that's fine. I don't know why no blogger has mentioned that this takes literally 1 hour to blend. Like, I've heard so many mixed reviews about this, but nobody ever said that it took so long, guys. My hands are literally aching, like my hands hurt. Guys, finish wise, I'm really liking this foundation. I am pretty impressed with the way it looks. Like, it does not look cakey, it does not look or feel heavy, but it's giving me a pretty good coverage. Time to highlight. I'm going to be using the Dermacolor Concealer. This is in the shade 4, so this is a shade lighter, and this I'm going to be using for highlighting. So first, taking it on to my under eyes, the bridge of my nose and my forehead, Cupid's bow, chin, and below where my contour is supposed to be. Again, with the silly sponge, I'm gonna blend all of this out. To set in all the areas that I've highlighted, I'm gonna be using the Faces Loose Powder.
Okay.
bronze up my face and to add a little more warmth, I'm going to be using the NYX Matte Bronzer in the shade Deep Tan. I'm using this brush that I got from Amazon and it's actually working pretty well. I'm giving them a shot for a while, so if it works well, then I'll definitely make a review on it. To add a touch of blush onto my cheeks, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Dream Touch Blush in the shade 05. For my brows today, I'm going to be using the NYX Eyebrow Pencil. So I'm going to first use the comb that comes along with it and brush out my brows. And in short strokes, I'm just going to fill them in. So I'm not going for a really like heavy look today. I want it to be really soft. So I'm not defining them too much, but just concentrating on filling them in. Starting off with the eye makeup, I'm going to be taking the L'Oreal La Palette Nude. This is the rose variant. I've hardly used this palette. I'm using it after so long. So I'm going to be first picking up this gray color right here. And I'm first taking it to my outer corner and just placing it there. I'm not concentrating on blending, guys. I'm just placing the color. Taking the same onto my inner corners really carefully. And now going with a fluffy brush, I'm just going to blend the edges out to get a nice soft blend. So what I'm doing is I'm blending the outer corner and then blending the inner corner and just slightly joining them, not much. So that acts like a crease as well. First blending the outer corner, then the inner, and now just joining these two. And now I'm just applying that color again, because I lost a bit of intensity while blending them. So now coming to the main lid color, I'm going to be picking this color right here from the palette. And I'm just placing it in that gap we left in the center. So if you can see, I'm tapping the color in. Generally, I would go up to down, but now I'm just tapping it in to bring a nice halo effect. So now using an empty blending brush, I'm just blending the lid color and the corner colors out. So now I feel like this needs a little brown to it. So I'm going to take my Maybelline Nudes palette and I'm going to pick up this color right here. And I've taken the tiniest amount on my blending brush and I'm just going over the gray. It might not look like much, but it definitely does make a difference. Like, I hope you guys can see the difference on this eye and on this eye. This looks a little more intense, a little more blended out than this one. Being extremely careful on the inner corners, you don't want to overdo it. This is one place where you can go wrong in a halo eye. You have to make sure you don't overdo your inner corners. And now going back in with the same lid color, I'm taking it on to my inner corners to highlight that as well. So for a bit more pop onto my eye, I'm going to be taking the Makeup Revolution Vivid Baked Highlighter, which is going to be my highlighter for today. And I'm just picking it up with my eyeshadow brush. And I'm just going to tap that over the halo. And you can instantly see that it adds a little more boost there. For my eyeliner today, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Colossal Liner. For mascara, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Colossal Volume Express. This is the waterproof variant. And I'm just giving a nice thick coat on my upper lashes and my lower lashes. Eyes all done, now time for some highlight, and I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution one, as I mentioned before. This is in the shade Pink Lights. For my lips, I'm going to be using the Lakme Absolute Argan Oil Lip Color. This is in the shade Soaked Berries. So that's it for this video, guys. I really hope you guys like this look. And if you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. The link is down below. You can also follow me on my Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat and Twitter. All the links are given in the bottom bar. And I'll see you soon in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.